History highlights. Memorable moments from the Council Bluffs metro area past. Presented by the Historical Society of Pottawatomie County.
Today, it looks quiet and peaceful. But what could have easily turned into the bloodiest moment in Council Bluffs history took place right here.
So there was a little fortress within Council Bluffs that if you came anywhere near the Squirrel Cage Jail, you had a gun pointed at you outside of a window. Every type of weapon you could imagine.
1932, and farmers went on strike.
These farmers didn't feel that they were getting paid well enough to bring grain into town. So they stopped bringing it in. Well, that upset the people here in town. And the sheriff was supposed to do something about that. So he talked to some other farmers who said, well, we'll bring the grain in. And so the first set of farmers didn't like that the other farmers were going to bring grain in, so they started setting up roadblocks and hazards and stuff like that, so people couldn't bring that produce and grain and milk into town. And they would knock down trees and telephone poles and stand out there with baseball bats and discourage any of these other farmers from bringing things into town. So we could house 90 comfortably here at the jail. Well, the sheriff actually went out and arrested every one of these picketers.
Sheriff Lanson stated, if the Pottawatomie County Jail bulges with picketers, it'll just have to bulge, because I'm going to fight it out if it takes 5,000 deputies.
And so now all of a sudden we've got 150, 160 farmers that were placed under arrest and housed in our facility. Well, that upset other farmers, and so they were going to bust them out of this jail.
As word spread, rumors had it that 1,000 men were on the way to Council Bluffs headed for the Squirrel Cage Jail. Their plan? Break the picketers out. Sheriff Lanson reported that if the jail was mobbed, his men were armed and would handle it. Deputies had been instructed to shoot to kill should anyone try and take the jail. The Daily Nonpareil published a front page warning to citizens to stay home and stay away from this area for their own safety.
Well, the sheriff at the time was Percy Lanson. He was also part of what we consider now the National Guard, and he had access to every type of weapon you could imagine. But that was very taxing on the few deputies and the few town marshals and police that we had at the time. So he swore in a bunch of special deputies. And a lot of these guys were military vets, and Claude Dale happened to be one of them.
Thursday, August 25th, there was gunfire and a tragedy. A special deputy had been shot.
He was recently divorced, moved up from Missouri, and he was living with his father here in town. And they swore him in as a special deputy. And within 3 days of him being sworn in, they were basically showing him how to use a riot gun. Well, that gun accidentally discharged. That gun discharged and ended up being a mortal wound, and he ended up dying as a result of that.
Though strikes continued elsewhere in the Midwest, by the end of August, the situation in Council Bluffs was essentially over. The tale of the lone casualty of the event, Deputy Claude Dale, came to a halt for over 80 years until it was discovered that his name wasn't listed on the National Law Enforcement Memorial Wall in Washington, D.C. Thanks to the efforts of the Historical Society, under the direction of Vice President Jason Leemaster, this has been corrected, and Deputy Dale's name was formally dedicated at the 26th Annual Candlelight Vigil during National Police Week.
The sheriff's office has had a total of five fallen officers, regrettably, and we have their names listed and memorialized here. This was part of the sheriff's office, and we want to make sure that history is not forgotten about.
You can see this memorial at the Squirrel Cage Jail Museum, 226 Pearl Street in Council Bluffs, Iowa.
History is never truly lost until it's forgotten, and preserving that history is our mission. The Historical Society of Pottawatomie County in Council Bluffs, Iowa.